doktor, sila nagbibigay ng ano ng you know, ng care sa ibang tao. Pero paano naman yung mga doktor na 'di ba ang tagal-tagal
which is the reason why for us we have an annual checkup.
Oo.
We consult each other.
Okay.
Like me, I do my annual and I just send my results to the friend cardiologist. I have myself checked. Then at some point I also consult, like I have sore throat all the time. So my friend pulmonologist say, though there's nothing wrong with you, but you have to stop talking.
Okay.
But what do you do? Early in the morning, 7 o'clock, I lecture up to 10. Then if I have an event like this, I talk. The afternoon or noon time, I still have patients. And I like talking to patients because I learn from them. It is not that they learn from me. Perhaps I also learn from them because what is their life that they're consulting to me is also useful to me. And I learn from them. The same way that I listen to people, it's the difference between. Maybe this is not the kind of medicine that the younger doctors are employing. But I think it's almost always important to listen to patients and to people around you.
Ma'am, yung ano po, bakit sa dinami-dami po ng specialty, ito po yung napili niyong, you know, tutukan? Tsaka anong meron dito at bakit kailangan talagang, ano yung dapat, yung pinakapuntong kailangan makuha ng tao?
Specialty, I like OB-GYN because OB, it's not only about healing a sick, it's delivering a life. So another life is very welcome. Why gynecology? Because it's an operative field. I am, if God gave me a skill, then I have to use it. Like if good surgeon, then it's good. And I learned, I knew that there's a trust for minimally invasive. I'm also a gyne-endoscopist. I started learning about it and getting myself tooled or skilled. Kahit na ang edad ko, 41, 42 na at the time. And people don't retrain after 40.
Yes.